Well, hi there, everybody. Isaac here. I hope everybody is doing well. I hope you guys had a good week last week. You know, certainly we're going through some difficult times right now. You know, I talked a little bit about this in my last video, and there's no question about it. We are going through so much right now as a nation, as a world, individually, right? There's just so much evil. We're truly living in some dark and some evil times. You think about the division in our country, the pandemic, the political corruption on all sides, the conspiracy theories galore, immoral laws, human trafficking, just to name a few things that are going on. And honestly, it's a mess right now. And, you know, if Jupiter had a habitable atmosphere, I think I would move to Jupiter right now. But it doesn't. Okay. So we're here on Earth. We're dealing with all these problems. And that's why today I want to talk a little bit about how we as believers should be walking in times such as these. Okay. What does the Bible tell us? Now, I want to share with you guys a short excerpt from Ephesians chapter 5, verses 15 through 16. Okay. And, here in Ephesians chapter 5, verses 15 through 16, the Apostle Paul writes, and I'm reading from the New King James Version of the Bible. He writes, "See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil." So if you look up that word circumspectly here in the Greek, in the original Greek language, that word is akribos. And that word, if you look it up, it's used to describe how we as believers should be living, how we should be walking. And the meaning there is diligently, perfectly, accuracy, which is the outcome of carefulness. Okay, so in other words, we as believers should be walking in such a way that we are well aware of the circumstances around us and the potential consequences. And, you know, every time I read these verses, and please don't judge me, what comes to my mind is maybe when we were younger and we snuck out of our parents' house, right? Maybe they grounded us. They didn't allow us to go to that Wilson Phillips concert, but we went anyway, so we snuck out of the house. Remember how you came back home late that night? You came back very carefully, didn't you? Number one, you were very careful of where you placed your feet, right? You didn't want to slip, you didn't want to fall, you didn't want to knock something over. Secondly, you were very careful of where you were looking. You didn't want to bump into a wall, bump into a vase, you know, step on the dog. Thirdly, we were very careful with our listening, right? We were listening for our parents. We were listening to see or to hear if somebody was still awake in the house. Fourthly, we were very careful of where we were placing our hands. We didn't want to knock anything over or bump into the wall with our hand. We wanted to make sure that everyone was still asleep so they wouldn't catch us coming into the house. Fifthly, we were guarding our mouth, right? We didn't want to sneeze. We didn't want to talk. We didn't want to cough. So we didn't wake anybody up. And then, of course, sixthly, we were carefully thinking about our next step, right? Our next move to get to the bedroom so they wouldn't catch us. We were sober-minded, and we didn't want to wake up our parents, right? And very similarly, this is how we want to be walking as believers. I know it sounds kind of weird, but we want to do this for the purposes of pleasing our Heavenly Father. Number one, we need to be very careful of where we are placing our feet, where and with whom you are hanging out with, right? 1 Corinthians 15:33 tells us, "Bad company corrupts good habits." The people, the places where we are spending the most time with and at, eventually we're going to become more like those people and those places. We're going to start looking more like those people and those places. So we need to be very, very careful. Secondly, we talked about the sight, right? As we're sneaking back into our parents' house. Similarly, as believers, we want to be careful what we are looking at and where we are looking, right? We don't want to put anything wicked or evil or something that could distract us before our eyes. Psalm 101, verse 3, "I will set nothing wicked before my eyes. I hate the work of those who fall away. It shall not cling to me." what we are reading, the blogs, the news outlets, right? They're all messed up. CNN, Fox News, everything, right? We need to be careful what we are looking at, what we are reading, which is then eventually making it to our mind, because that can cause problems for us. Thirdly, we need to guard our hearing, right? We don't want to, we want to be very careful of whom and what we are listening to, right? Proverbs 20 verse 12 tells us, the hearing ear and the seeing eye, the Lord has made them both. So obviously, those two are made for his glory and for his own desire. So we have to be very, very careful. Fourthly, the touch, right? We want to keep our hands to ourselves. We want to be careful where we are placing our hands, what we are touching, anything that could cause us to stumble, right? Hebrews 5:14 reminds us that as we grow in the word, as we grow in the Lord, we will be able to discern between what is right and what is wrong. Fifthly, our mouths. And I think this is a hard one, especially in the days we're living in. We need to guard our mouths. And, you know, these are days where everybody has to be right. Everybody has to win the argument. But we don't want to grieve the Holy Spirit around us, right? Ephesians 4:29 tells us, let no corrupt word proceed out of your mouth, but what is good for necessary edification or the building up of the church, that it may impart grace to the hearers. And then lastly, our minds. We want to guard those minds, right? And that's where the battle begins, doesn't it? 2 Corinthians 10:5 tells us, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. And when we live like this as believers, we can certainly fulfill what Paul tells us here in verse 16. He tells us, redeeming or making the most of the time because the days are evil. And what should we be doing with that time? Redeeming it, right? But what should we be doing with the time, right? Well, number one, I truly believe we should be growing in the Lord. And number two, we should be building God's kingdom by pointing people to Jesus. Not a politician, not a movement, not a conspiracy theory, not a lifestyle, but to Jesus. Because only he can save us. Nothing else can. Amen. All right, guys, I'll be praying for you. I love you guys, but remember, God loves you more. Have a blessed week. And as I told you guys last time, keep looking up. Do not lose hope. All right. What seems to be hopeless, don't lose hope in a hopeless world. Amen. Have a blessed week, and I'll see you guys again soon.